facial expression editing, hand fixing, find and replace, blending, post-referencing. These are just a taste of the powerful features waiting for you in OpenArt AI. Hey everyone, this is Mia, and today I'm so excited to walk you through OpenArt AI, a seriously advanced AI image generator and editor. Whether you're a complete beginner looking for quick prompting shortcuts, or a seasoned user excited to explore advanced comfy UI workflow, there's something here for everyone. Today's video is sponsored by OpenArt AI. I believe this tool offers some unique capabilities that are definitely worth checking out. Let me show you their platform. When we log into OpenArt AI, we'll see three primary options right away. Create image, edit image, and train your custom models. There are also plenty of other tools underneath these main options. Most of these tools are accessible directly within the editing interface, so you won't need to hop around too much. Let's jump into creating images. Inside the panel, you'll see a variety of features on the left, but first let's create an image. The first thing we'll see is the custom setting button, where you can select a custom setting you set before, save your current settings, or pick from the preset styles they have. Click view more styles and you'll be taken to the style palette page. Here you can browse through a wide range of styles. Clicking a style will load the model, and a default prompt will also be added as a starting point for you to create your own version. Of course, you can always tweak this prompt to match your vision. Let's pick a different model here. There's so many different models you can choose from. You can find lots of different advanced models like Flux, Color, or even DALL-E 3 here. It's really nice to have so many model options in one platform. If you've trained your own model, you can also find it in My Models. For this example, I'll pick Flux Realism. Now let's input a prompt, a photo of a beautiful woman in a bookstore. If you're not feeling super creative or need help enhancing your prompt, just use the enhance prompt feature. The quick enhance will let AI add more details to your original prompt, or if you need more control, click customize prompt. You can specify more control in terms of color scheme and style of the enhanced prompt. If you're creating an image that looks like another image, we can also use image to prompt to ask AI to generate the text prompt based on an image. After the prompt is loaded, further adjust the text prompt to make sure it fit our vision. We can then adjust the prompt adherence. A lower setting gives the AI more creative freedom, while a higher setting makes it stick closely to your instructions. And we can also use an image as a reference to generate a similar image. You can even ask the AI to further describe this image and put it in the text prompt to enhance the overall prompt. Depending on the model you choose, you may have different control in terms of what you can reference. For example, stable diffusion-based models often have more control, like image reference, style reference, pose reference, composition, and face reference, or other control net reference. If you pick a model like DALL-E 3, you'll only have control over the text prompt. In the advanced setting, we can set how long AI runs before generating the result. Higher is generally better, but to a certain degree. You can also adjust the output image size using presets or custom dimensions. We can pick how many images we want to generate at a time, and you'll notice the credits cost change when you adjust this number. Let's click create. Here are the results. And all the details you use to prompt this are going to be on the site. We can save and share. We can also upscale this image, create variations. Up top, there are many other features to further edit this image. To be more organized, we can select the images and add them to an album. And under album, we can find the album that contains the images we just put in. And all the other images you've generated would be under here. Let's further edit this image. Just click the edit button to send this image to the editing board. Once we're in the editing section, you'll notice a variety of AI tools at the top. Here's a quick overview of what you can do. InPaint can edit or add elements to specific areas of the image. Remove unwanted objects, expand, transform your image style, remove or replace the background, adjust facial expressions, fix hands and faces, merge and blend different elements into a seamless image, find and replace, upscale to enhance the resolution of the image. There are just so many different things you can do here. Let's start by changing the background. select the image first and then click on the background tool. And the AI will automatically identify and separate the subject from the background. Once it's done, the background will be highlighted in green. Then there we can either change the background with something new or remove it entirely for a transparent backdrop. Let's go ahead and change the background. So first we describe what we want the new background to be. Let's say a coffee shop. Add negative prompts to specify what we don't want to include. We can upload an image to guide the AI in generating the new background. For this example, let's upload a coffee shop image. Set the AI to match the style of the original image. We'll generate 4 variations and click create to see the results. Seems like they are ready. Let's click to preview. I think the subject is blended pretty well with the background and the AI did a great job applying the design from my reference image. We can see the same black window frames and wood table. Similar lighting here. It also maintains proper proportion and perspective relative to the subject pretty well. Although I had to say there seem to be some oddities still. Maybe the reference image was too complicated. Like there seem to be some weird utensils in these cups. Not sure what this is. I do like that they have quite a few bakery collections. From what I look, it feels like the light is outside here. Let's try another batch. Click back to edit. And try again with another image. And they all look pretty good. If you click Add to Canvas, the new image will be added alongside your current ones, so you can compare them side by side. Click Select to replace the current image with the new one. At the top left, you'll find the Select tool to select and move things around. The Hand tool lets you move the whole canvas, and the Move tool is for repositioning specific elements. You can also add text or shapes to customize your design. Now let's clean up this clutter table. We'll use the Remove tool. Quick Erase lets you quickly brush away parts of the image. You can quickly touch up. When you brush over the image, the item will disappear. For more complex objects, use Magic Erase. To make selections on OpenArt AI, Click Area will analyze the image and allow you to select isolated parts. This saves time and your efforts into selecting each part one by one. For more control, we can click Manual Brush and adjust the size. And brush over the area we want to select when we are in Add mode. Switch to the minus mode to remove things from your selection. Inverse option lets you quickly select the opposite area. Undo and redo to go back and forth in your steps. Let's do Magic Erase. For the Magic Erase, we can adjust the creativity level. It recommends a lower level for a simple background and a higher level for a more complicated background. Now, click Remove now. Okay, it seems like the table is now missing and the coffee cup is just floating somewhere. We'll need to add a table back to the image using InPaint. Let's select the area where the table should be and maybe we'll also change the cup. Now let's input a text prompt, a wood table with a cup of coffee on top. We'll use a realistic model. Seems like you could use a reference image with this model to generate the content. I'll skip that for now. There are many other parameters you can adjust in the advanced setting. Once you're done setting up, then click Create. Some of the tables seem to be cutting into her a bit too much, maybe a little bit uncomfortable. So we may need to edit the details some more. I'll pick this one and remove one of the white plate here. Now let's add some room to our image. Click Expand. You'll see the green border which you can drag to resize your image. On the right under Output Size, we can also select from Preset Aspect Ratio. The canvas border will change according to your selection. You can move both the border and the image within it to reposition them. We can also adjust the width and height directly like this, and the aspect ratio will remain consistent. If you like, you can add a prompt to guide the expansion. We can also use an image as a guide, but we'll skip that for now. Let's click Create. I think they look great. The overall perspective and angles are very impressive. Now let me show you a seriously cool feature, Find and Replace. This tool lets you replace any item in your image just by describing what to remove and what to add. Let's say we want to search for a book and replace with an iPad. So let's try it. I am super impressed. I love how you don't need to select an area first. You just prompt and it changes. Sometimes it's hard to judge the size and area you need to select, but this simplifies everything. I think all of them actually look great. This one's middle finger seems a bit long for a human, but I like this iPad, so let's add this to the canvas. Alright, let's fix that alien hand. Click the Edit People tool, select the hand area, and click Correct Hands. You can add a description, but it's optional. These are definitely improvements. The regenerated hands are much better proportionally. It also seems to take the hand's position and interaction with the iPad into consideration. These hands really do look like they belong to her. You can also do the same thing with the face, and the results are mind-blowing. The facial features are all more crisp and clear than before. They're gorgeous, but I'm kind of attached to her face now, so I'll skip it. But we'll fix the blurriness later using another tool. Alright you guys, this is seriously my absolute favorite feature and the most fun I've had on OpenArt AI. Being able to easily change your character's facial expressions. Just click the face tool. With a few clicks, you can instantly apply preset expressions like happy, wink, surprised, sleepy, frown, or even looking away. You can tweak everything. We can move her head vertically up and down, horizontally right and left, and tilt her head side right and left. It's amazing how these small tweaks totally change the character's emotions. You can change her mouth to smile wider, more open mouth or closed, change her mouth width and the roundness. We can change the blink to be more open or closed, her eye direction to right or left, and even move the eyebrows higher for a surprise look. We can even add a wink. You can really create the exact emotion you're looking for. And now you can control your image like a puppet. So what caught her attention? Let's find out using this super useful blend tool, which combines multiple elements into a seamless image. First, click blend layer to turn our image into a blend board. This defines the final image area. You can adjust its size as needed. Now let's add an image layer here. I'm uploading this kitten. The tool automatically removes the background. You can see all your layers in the layer panel. I'm gonna resize and reposition the cat here. Next, we select our blend setting. Auto gives both strong and subtle blends, so let's pick that. You can also adjust the creativity level, lower for simple backgrounds, higher for complex ones. Let's blend. Okay, in this case, the strong blend recreate the entire scene. I feel that it has strayed too much from the original composition. Although it is more cohesive, it does seem to have changed the original image too much. Actually, in my previous tries, it sometimes can actually preserve the composition better than this one. The subtle blend preserves the original composition. We can see the lighting has changed and the fur of the cat is blended with the background. I think the cat is perfectly blended into the scene. Though the girl has some blurriness and artifacts because I have made too many changes to her for demonstration purposes, but we can fix all that in the next section. Okay, let's upscale this image. On the upscale panel, we have three choices: precise, refine, and creative. Each one offers a different approach, so let's try them all to see what happens. The precise upscale enhances resolution while preserving the original style and faces. The image is crisper, but everything stays exactly where it was. The refine upscale adds the subtle AI-generated enhancements. It gives richer textures and a polished look. The details are cleaned up, but the overall composition remains pretty much the same. We can see that the face of both the girl and the cat have changed, even the expressions. The creative upscale adds significant details and changes, and even transforms styles and subjects for a high quality creative result. Now the characters look like they fully belong in the scene. The background is more refined, though these are definitely not the same characters anymore. I think this tool is a great alternative to solutions like Magnific. If you work with AI image generation, you'll know how essential a good upscaling tool is. Now let's transform this image with the stylized feature. You can use a reference image to guide the style or choose from the provided examples. We can adjust how much the style affects the image, add a prompt for more control. Let's try a few of their examples. These images keep its original structure and composition, but now it's showing a variety of unique stylistic results. OpenArt AI also offers powerful features like training your own custom models. Whether you're focusing on a style, character, face, or object, you can explore the community feed to see the prompts others are using and get inspired. If you find something you like, simply hit remix to reuse the exact same settings. Additionally, you can access comfy UI workflows directly on their cloud. Just request cloud space via their Discord. The Comfy UI Academy section provides resources to help you to the deep end of comfy UI. All right, let's talk pricing. OpenArt AI offers several plans to fit different needs. Free plan, you get 40 credits for 7 days, but they won't replenish after their use. So on their basic plan, it includes 2,500 credits per month. Advanced plan provides 10,000 credits per month, plus access to features like training personalized models, ultimate upscaling, blend board, people editor, and other premium AI tools. The infinite plan offers 20,000 credits per month with everything included in the advanced plan, more things like bulk creation and priority support. These premium features are worth it depending on your needs and what you're looking to do. Plus, with my special discount code, you can get an extra 20% off on any plan. Check the link and discount code below to give it a try. Overall, I think it is an impressive platform that brings together so many cutting-edge AI features. I had a blast using it, and I hope you enjoyed this walkthrough. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.